Hey there, today we're going to talk about articulation. Why? Because I have received a million emails in my inbox and here on YouTube to discuss it, so it's high time we do it. Now, at its most basic, articulation is simply stopping the reed from vibrating with your tongue. Nothing more, nothing less. Now, obviously, articulation takes many forms as we're playing, but it's really, at again, its most basic, how long you're holding your tongue on the reed. Okay? I'll give you an example. Now, legato, I'm going to blow, and I'm just going to touch the reed gently with my tongue, and then release my tongue. And as I'll play this scale, you hear just a little bit of articulation. This is legato. Now, staccato is the same thing, except instead of blowing and letting the reed vibrate, I'm holding my tongue on the reed so it doesn't vibrate, and then just releasing my tongue a little bit and then putting it back on the reed so the reed stops vibrating. Okay? So that's all the difference there is. I'm not pushing on the reed any harder. I am not hammering on the reed with my tongue. I am not squeezing it with my tongue. I'm just keeping it from vibrating with my tongue, okay? The other thing that I'm doing is I'm continuing to support my air, like I was doing with legato, because obviously you can't get the reed to vibrate if you're not pushing air through it. But some of us forget that when we're not getting sound out because the reed is not vibrating, we still need to support with our air, okay? Super, super important. So now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a quick exercise. I want you to take your finger, I'd like you to put it up against your lips and blow through it with a sort of a relaxed clarinet-y kind of embouchure, okay? Great. Now, what I want you to do is do the same thing, but then take your tongue and touch it to your knuckle. What that does is it stops the air, obviously, from going through your lips. With your tongue acting kind of like a stopper, like a valve, sort of like your sink stopper, okay? So that's all it takes. Now, when you release your tongue and let the air start flowing again, you're going to notice something. And what you're going to notice is that there's this little kind of articulation sound. It's probably the best way to put it. Now, what you're doing, you're noticing you're not hitting the reed or doing anything special with your tongue. You're just opening the valve. Okay? So think about that for a second. It's the same thing as on the bass clarinet. So let's do it on the bass clarinet. And let me give you this exercise where I want you to play for, I'm going to set my metronome at 120 or whatever, and I'm going to play a whole note, and then I'm going to continue to support my air, but with my tongue on the reed. Now you're going to hear the reed vibrating a little bit because we're just gently putting our tongue on the reed. Why? Because I want you to practice supporting your air even though the reed isn't vibrating. Okay? So here we go. So four beats playing, and then four beats holding my tongue on the reed, and then four beats playing, etc. I'm going to play a G major scale. So you can do this either on a scale or just by playing the same note over and over, but the most important thing is to continue to let the reed vibrate even though your tongue is on it. Now it's going to tickle a little bit, you're going to have to get used to it. And let's do it on open G. Done that, simply you just go to half notes and you let the reed vibrate for two beats and then you put your tongue on it for two beats, etc. Let's do that now. Notice that it's getting a little bit sharper as I touch the reed with my tongue. That's okay because this is just practice. Okay, so you have done that. And you have done that for a few minutes, or maybe even 5 or 10 minutes, and you go to quarter notes. And then you go to eighth notes. You seeing a pattern here? And then gradually, you can even do 16th notes. Okay, so what that does when I'm playing the 16th notes is I'm going da la 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 like that. It's really kind of going la 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 la. Okay. Now, when you want to actually play staccato, because that's not a real staccato sound, because you're still hearing the reed vibrating, you simply touch the reed a little bit, with a little bit more pressure with your tongue. But hold on, let me back up for a second. Some of you may be saying, wait a minute, I can't get the reed to continue vibrating as I'm blowing and have my tongue on the reed. And that may be for a couple of reasons. It may be that you have a very soft reed, and so by just touching the reed with your tongue, you're completely closing it off. It may be that you are pushing too hard with your tongue, in which case, lay off a little bit and just touch it even more lightly. I know that it tickles. I know it feels really weird. Get over it. So, anyway, back up to what I was saying, which is when you want to start playing staccato, you simply just hold it a little bit tighter. I'm sorry, it's not the right word. Touch it a little bit harder with your tongue, but you're not clamping down on it. The reason that you have to remember to the thing you have to remember is to continue blowing as you're playing the staccato notes. Okay, so the sound of an articulation, sort of to wrap this up, is not the sound of the tongue on the reed. The sound of an articulation is the sound of the reed beginning to vibrate. If you hear a lot of tongue sound on your reed, that's because you are squeezing too hard with it. Okay, so that is staccato. Now legato we're going to talk about for just another minute. Legato, again, is the same thing except you're just brushing your tongue on the reed. You don't want the reed to really stop vibrating when you're playing legato. And then when you want to get really advanced, you get into things called ghosting. Now, ghosting is what we do in jazz. And that, again, is by holding your tongue on the reed. But that's for a different episode. Okay? Hope this was helpful. We will see you next time. Take care.